Let's see how long we go before Facebook decides to kick us off. They've been known to do that. All right, so I asked friends for route suggestions from downtown here in San Diego State, which is where KPBS, San Diego's PBS and NPR affiliate is located. And what I got were some pretty evil routes. All the construction still happening. Nice to know that building luxury condos is considered an essential service. Look at that. 8th and Broadway. Still banging away. So what I got were some evil routes from some of my more evil friends. Hang on, more construction still happening. Look at those guys. All standing right next to each other, got their arms around each other over there in that construction site. Why are those guys still working? This Broadway. I'm gonna go all the way down. I'm not gonna do any of the routes, the evil routes. Wake up at 4 a.m. and ride 100 miles. Okay, that's just mean. There's no way I can work after riding 100 miles. Market to Euclid? No, Market Euclid, that's the four corners of death. Look at this guy. He's got his wall goose there. Fat tire wall goose. Sure, I'd get more creative routes, but guess not. So, I made one of my own, which is something we haven't done, which is go down Broadway. The reason I never go down Broadway is because there's too much traffic, but... Normally, even at this time, 20 to 7, this would be a really busy part of town. But nobody's at the bus stop. Got a few sailors walking over there, and that's about it. Morning. here because this is the PCH. And again, this is another road I would never come down in more normal times. They kind of left it open. A lot of the city stuff, they actually put gates up and have police sitting at. It's right up this way. I wonder if they have the gates open in their restrooms here. Nope, looks like the restrooms are still open. So if you gotta pee. Conferences about the coronavirus in the county of San Diego. It runs all the way up to LA. Valley.
turbine on the left here. Actually, a lot of aero studies happen there. And then you got the big tunnels.
Still fish.
Again, I would never come down this road. Normally, it's just that, there's no traffic. If this was a normal commute, I would be a completely different place. Especially when you get around tourists. People, when they're on vacation, tend to skunk. Because they're confused, they tend to drive a little more erratically. Ooh. Man, what did someone drag that skunk all this way? Oh man, maybe that car hit it. It smells. Wind tunnel on your left. Actually, the San Diego Air and Space Technology Center. They've got a wind tunnel there. I think Team Sky was in there doing wind tunnel testing at one point. So, Port of San Diego building on your right. I'm sure they're doing a lot of work from home now too. And on your left is the rental car center. So, many people rent cars because nobody's traveling. This is Sassafras Street on the PCH crossing Sassafras Street. That parking lot is even closed. Look at that, I didn't even realize there was a bike lane here. It's been so long since I've come up this way. What the hell are all these people doing? Those are delivery trucks. I bet the delivery trucks are not used to seeing people ride their bikes down here because, most people avoid it. It's so dangerous. lot more common than you would think. It was on the heels of a series of arrests where some hotel managers and owners up in North County were arrested for running prostitutes out of their hotels. You know? That's very different when you're involved as opposed to just renting a room to someone, because you have no idea what you're gonna do if you rent the room to someone. You hope they don't do anything illegal or dangerous, but at the end of the day, who's got control over what other people do? Extended stay over there. Some office parks here, residents.
Curious. Place here goes all the way back up into Hillcrest, but we're gonna keep going. Go out through Mission Valley. You know, the app I use to stream these is only streaming to Facebook these days. I cannot get it to stream through stream to YouTube, so fortunately this is only going to Facebook. I wish it wasn't, but maybe what I'll do is I'll hopefully be able to upload this to YouTube and maybe Twitter. Some people might be interested. All this construction down here. Camino de la Arena. Poor guy over there. Still doing construction. On your left here is the old Union Tribune building. Used to be where the newspaper was. My grandfather was with the Tribune. Originally they were downtown. And then they moved here to Mission Valley. I want to say in the 60s. Stayed here for the rest of the time. until paper damn near folded. Tribune Company bought it up. It was not pretty. A bunch of people are getting offered buyouts now. Building's empty. They've moved back into just regular office space. And most of them are working downtown. My question is, are working at home? More construction going on. Hey man, gotta build those luxury condos. Need more $3,000 a month studio apartments. Get the homeless off the street, right? Right? That'll solve the problem. Anyhow, I digress. Oh man, housing. What a train wreck. Construction workers. A lot of UT reporters and one photo guy now taking the buyout. But a lot of those people, at least this one guy taking the buyout, he doesn't need to work. So perfectly okay for him to do that. He owns his house outright as two other condos. I mean, come on, you know? Seriously. You know? I'd love to be paid enough to own a home in San Diego. That should be sort of the minimum. But I don't think there are any jobs that pay that much. One of the few actual residence housing on your left here, that's apartments here in this valley. They're always renting. I think they're way overpriced for what they are. More construction on your right for more extremely high-end housing. That will of course remain empty. Are always available. Nobody can afford it. This is normally a shit show this time of the morning. This is right now. This is still rolling. Look at that, still rolling. You know, if you're gonna commute by bike, now is a great time to do it. I wonder if I gotta hit the button. This is gonna change. Nope. Rad. Pickups there. Already a line going out the door. People to get in. Get some toilet paper. Mm-hmm. toilet paper. How stupid was that? You know what I mean? Now people are out there buying up orange juice because they think it's got a lot of vitamin C and that'll protect them. What a bunch of idiots. You know what else has a lot of vitamin C? Brussels sprouts. Do we have a Brussels sprout shortage? Come on. Get yourselves together here, all right? Stop listening to YouTubers. Stop letting them make your decisions for you. Come on. Don't be a jerk. See those videos online of people with F-150s full of nothing but toilet paper? What a bunch of jerks. Try and sell and profiteering off that hand sanitizer. I'll tell you, here in San Diego, they're getting arrested, so they should, because it's a crime. Profiteering is a crime, because it should be a crime. I mean, come on. There are people you have to explain this to? Seriously, there are adults you have to explain why profiteering is a crime to. Jesus fucking Christ. Stop behaving like a bunch of children, alright? What I think you should do is if you find someone who's been hoarding all the toilet paper and a garage full of it or whatever, just go to their house. Shit on their front step. They've got all the toilet paper. I'm kidding. Don't be stupid. Don't break the law. Shitting on someone's front step is definitely not legal. Although in this context, I believe morally justified, but still not legal. But don't go pooping in people's property. See how long this takes. This light's gonna change if I need to hit. There's no button to hit. Hey, hey. Look at those clouds. Yeah, there is no button to hit here, so. Anticipating I'm gonna have to blow through this light unless it changes. Yep. Alright. I got a car behind me, they'll hit the light. It'll trigger now. Things I do when I get up to my desk is go make coffee. Because right now I think I'm the only get by with one pot at work. Newsroom, that's like a miracle. I used to come this way going home a lot. Rarely came this way going to work because, you know, morning traffic. Regular days, I definitely don't like coming this way. In general, either direction. People drive pretty irrationally. Oh, man. This road's pretty bumpy, so hopefully we don't lose the feed. Underneath the 805 freeway now. San Diego River on our left. There's some housing over there. Definitely very expensive. Two bedroom will run you almost $3,000 a month. To live next to a river that is full of, you know, poop, runoff, and that smells occasionally, you know. San Diego River is not the river in San Diego that gets all of the sewage from Mexico as a result of Mexico's failing infrastructure, because Mexico City can't seem to build sewers. That river is called the Tijuana River. Tijuana River crosses the border right near the port of entry, actually, and comes into San Diego there, empties out in IB. However, most of what's flowing in that is just raw sewage. And that's because the Mexican government is not able or capable or interested in, I think interested is a key element, in building proper sewage for citizens. But, you know, sewage is a socialist idea. Sewers, roads, police, fire. Those are great education, socialist advancements, and hardcore libertarians think you should be able to pay for your own sewage, school, police, fire, roads. So there you go. I think that's more of what's happening in Mexico. That, and you know, Mexico City can't seem to help people outside of Mexico City. They can barely control Mexico City. So actually, turn right here. Because we gotta get on the other side of the freeway. Crossing back over the 8. People still driving. We'll take a peek, see what it's like. You know, I gotta say, looks like a normal holiday traffic. A lot of people going west. No, hardly anybody going east. That is the County of San Diego's Behavioral Health Services Center immediately in front of us here on Camino del Rio South. Called that because we are on the Camino of the river on the south side. There is a Camino del Rio North, which is on the north side of the river. heard hospitals in New York have an urgent nationwide call out for Spanish translators. Many translators of many different languages, but from what I saw, it said particularly Spanish. They want to be able to Zoom or Skype in somehow. Man, that's got to be rough. Saw videos of people loading up bodies into the back of a refrigerated truck. Old family friend lives in New York, Bill Ritter. He's on quarantine at home. I hope he's okay. You know, Bill Ritter's a sweet guy. He was always a sweet guy, even back when I was a little kid, which was a long, long time ago. Nothing but office parks over here. Nobody lives here. Well, the homeless live here. I suppose one or two dudes whose wife kicked them out. Sure that happens. But they're more like sleeping here. They don't really live here. Here I could turn right, go back up into Kensington, or I can go straight and climb Montezuma, which I would normally never do because of the traffic. But you know what, it's so light today, I think I'm gonna take a chance on Montezuma. Hopefully it doesn't kill me. Knock on wood, bite your tongue. Satellite campus here. Main campus is in Point Loma. More office buildings. It's weird to see people driving in and out now. There's a school over there for special education. Yeah. is technically Kensington, although I don't think from here you really have any access to any part of Kensington, but the zip code, so you can say, oh, I live in Kensington. But you can't, like, you know, walk to the cafe or whatever. But yeah, it's technically Kensington. But I would still consider this Mission Valley. Coming up out of Mission Valley, a couple of mattresses on your right. There you go. Huh? I'm sure they're totally fine. Palm trees on your left. They burnt up a little while ago. Got hot and dry and something happened. Hot on fire. So you'll see this part up here, where you come off of Camino del Rio south onto Fairmont. And then you have to cross over here where there's no bike lane and hope people aren't doing 50 miles an hour around India, because they're all trying to cross over. Get on to Fairmont. You're now on Montezuma. Then when you come up here, it's another on-ramp from Fairmont to Montezuma that you gotta cross over. That most people simply hit the gas through. That's the on-ramp again. Here's the off-ramp from Fairmont. Then you gotta cross this again. Hoping people will slow down. And you get a little bit of a bike lane here. It sort of widens up. It's a little bit more first world as we get further up the hill. However, as you will see soon, the bike lane on Montezuma disappears. This is the bike lane. You got a shoulder on your left, lane on your right. Shoulder's okay. However, when people have problems, they never stop in the shoulder, which is where they're supposed to. They always pull over all the way in to the bike lane because nobody tells them, don't park in the bike lane. Cyclist going down Montezuma. Going down Montezuma here is a whole other kettle of fish. So when they widened this, and when they tore up the asphalt that had the old bike lane markings, but they have yet to smooth it over. So no one wants to ride on that because it does that.
Now here's another crap crossing where you gotta cross over Montezuma for people that want to turn right onto Colwood. It becomes more difficult because the hill, the grade, starts to creep up here. Right around 5% at this point. To Montezuma so they get down to the 8 freeway. Still looks pretty busy if you ask me. Yeah, still flowing. Look at that. You should see how that bike lane changed. Went from a nice wide one with bollards and bollards and a decent little shoulder. Now it's just a line of paint pavement here. Oh look, and it gets skinnier as you go up the hill. What brilliant street design, huh? On your right is a gated community. Fancy people live there, do fancy things. Even though there's plenty of room for both car lane and a painted shoulder, which would of course encourage people to ride their bikes to, I don't know, campus instead of parking. But then you'd have to pay. People wouldn't be paying the however much it costs to park their car on campus every year. Faculty, staff, it is $30 a month, roughly. And there still isn't enough parking. See people, kids, students walking up this way too. It's like, what the hell, man? There's even a sidewalk on the other side of the street. What a bunch of poor planning. Sunny out, isn't it? I don't think I'm gonna need to wear the long sleeves. It's gonna be like this